Honorable Chairperson, before I conclude, let me go back to Honorable Lekota. Honorable Lekota, who is now absent, perhaps the more important, the more appropriate question to have asked would have been, how did COPE get here? From the 30 members that we have to what we currently have. So I think that's the more pertinent question you should pose to yourself about whether you will be here next year. Honorable Mazoni. Honorable Mazoni. You know that there's a review of state-owned enterprises, and the president has announced the reconfiguration of government. So the ANC government is working on the issues you are raising. But we know what you are raising is that you want us to sell state-owned assets. And to you, we must say, if that's what you want, tough luck. And I think you need a rescue plan for the DA here in the city of Cape Town. Honorable Mlausi, you forgot in your list to add to your list that those responsible for the VBS collapse must be locked up. Honorable Mulder, it is through the ANC, it is throughout the ANC's life, the ANC has sought to unite the people of South Africa. Unlike you, Honorable Mulder, with due respect, who represent the interests not of white people, but just a section of the white population. Now, you can't come here and argue that the ANC does not represent the interests of the people of South Africa as a whole. When we discuss expropriation of land, President Ramaphosa came to stand here and convinced you that let us not divide the people of South Africa over land expropriation, but let us unite so that we can move together forward as South Africans. So, Honorable Chair, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you. Thank you. In accordance with Rule 93, I will allow Honorable Madisha to conclude the debate.
Thank you, Chairperson. Honorable Tseke, you state that President Ramaphosa will continue to work towards economic growth. Are you aware that President Ramaphosa, at the heads of a mission conference held last week, he admitted that corruption has become so endemic that South Africa was, and I wish to quote, a failing state. That's what he said. The ANC does not have a good story to tell. Currently, the debt to GDP stands on almost 3 trillion rand, meaning 54.88% of the GDP. The interest SA pays per every second amounts to 5,477 rand. That's per second. Every citizen in our country is indebted as we speak now with 54,662 rands. The Minister of Finance projected debt to increase to 59% of GDP. We need to ensure that wrongdoers face consequences and the might of law. We as South Africans cannot continue to defend the indefensible. Honorable Singh, you're correct. This cancer has spread to every organ of state. Honorable Majeke, in 2011, late President Mandela lamented, let me quote him, little did we suspect that our people when they got a chance, would be as corrupt as the apartheid regime. That is one of the things that has really hurt us, unquote. Honorable Melde, you hit the nail right on the head. We have to rekindle the principle that South Africa belongs to all who live in it. Victimization and racism must stop. South Africa belongs to all who live in it. Honorable Meshwe, I agree with you. We have to ensure that wrongdoers face consequences and the might of law. To ensure food security, we need to provide tax rebates to agriculture to create jobs. There is a need to provide rebates to re-establish our textile industry that has been destroyed by cheap Chinese imports. To our fellow South Africans, we say, the future is in your hands. You have the power to determine our destiny. But then with ANC, forget about them.
Thank you.
They will kill you.
Thank you. Honorable Minister.
Chairperson, just for the record, I'd like to correct the impression that has been given by Honorable Madisha. The President did not say
Honorable,
we are a failing state.
Okay.
Point of order.
Honorable. Honorable Sisulu, I think that one is a point of debate. Can we leave it? It cannot be a point of order. Thank you.
Chairperson?
What is...
Misrepresentation. Point of order, if you recognize me. The minister should know that if you want to take a point of order, you've got to do it immediately while the debate's happening.
Thank you, Honourable Member. I think I've ruled already on that matter. I don't expect any further points of orders on that. That concludes the debate on this subject.